I was walking in from lunch and I saw my friend Samaita, and she like slipped on the ground because her boots were wet.
My name is Samira.
I'm Samaita.
My name is Abhinaya.
I'm Nubla.
And I'm Jyothika.
Everyone started laughing at me because like I look ridiculous on the floor. So we were like, oh, it was a problem, right?
So we came up with a device that we thought would suck up all the water from wet boots, so then incidents like that happened to Samaita wouldn't happen ever again.
We also went on a few websites to see how vacuums work.
Basically, it's a machine that dries your footwear. You would put your boots or your shoes on top of the rack, and the machine itself would suck the water. Your shoes would be dry by the end of the day.
Our design would use recycled materials like a plastic bottle, an old cookie rack, and a piece of cheesecloth to catch the moisture from the shoes. We cut up a pop can to make blades and attach them to the small DC motor to create a fan that would create suction.
This is how it works. We have two batteries here, 1.5 volts, and then we use the safety pin as a switch to turn it on, so it works like that. It goes in and then it turns on. And then we have a fan made out of a pop can. It works now.
And then on top of it, to prevent water from going through it, you would put the net on top, so then it would catch all the water and any like dirt or anything that goes in.
There you go. And then you can put the lid on top and the funnel as well.
We took a few cookie racks, right? And we connected them with the zap straps.
We put it in our locker and we left it there for like 20 to 30 minutes. And we came back and our shoes were still wet. And it didn't really work.
We made some like key changes, like changing the first DC motor from a 3-volt to a 9-volt because we thought it would have more power and it would provide more suction.
So this is our second prototype of our footwear dehydrator. At the bottom we have our 9-volt DC motor because the last one we had was 3 volts, so we thought it would be better if we used a higher powered one. We also have it connected to our fan made from scratch of a pop can. And then we connected it to it with a glue gun.
And since it's a bigger bottle, we need to use a bigger piece of cheesecloth to catch the moisture.
Now we have the top part of the bottle, right, which sits on top of the cheesecloth. We decided to use a bigger bottle, and for that we would make a bigger fan, and the bigger fan would lead to a bigger funnel to create more area for the water to fall into.
We put the second prototype in the locker. But then, when we opened the locker 30 minutes later, the battery had died because of the more powerful motor.
We decided to reduce the voltage from 9 volt to 6 volt, since 9 volt was more powerful and it died quicker. So we used 4 1.5 volt batteries to create 6 volts of power. We made some better fan blades that were angled more to create more suction. We decided to replace the cheesecloth with a more water-resistant rubber material, which would hold the water better.
Finally, we put our third prototype in the locker. And 45 minutes later, we checked and the shoes were dry.
Guys, it worked!
Oh, yes!
Working in a group was a really good bonding experience for us all.
Yeah, we really enjoyed it.
Because we all have everything we need to have like a great group all together.
Yeah, so.
And here we are, we succeeded.
Yeah.
Yay! Yeah.